Okay, in practice too, what you're going to do is the inverse mechanisms. You are going to construct the inverse mechanisms of Faubourg mechanism. Okay. So in Faubourg mechanism, there are four types of Faubourg mechanisms. So in Faubourg mechanism, there will be four links, and those four links are connected in series or in a circular manner. Okay. But what type of pair we are going to use depends on that. It can be classified. Okay, it can be classified into four ways. So, for example, if you see this mechanism, in this mechanism, all the pairs are just revolute pair. Okay. So this is being represented as RR RR. Okay. Now, if you see in this mechanism, we have replaced one of the R pair into a sliding pair. So that has been represented as RR RP. Okay. And in these two mechanisms, we have removed one more revolute pair and we have put a prismatic pair. For example, in this case, we have removed this revolute pair and we have put the prismatic pair. So therefore, this is called RRPP. Okay, this is RPRP. That's because if you see in this mechanism, two revolute pairs are adjacent to each other, where in this case, two revolute pairs are not adjacent to each other. Okay, so a prismatic pair will be next to a revolute pair, okay, or in between two revolute pair. Okay, so that's how these two things are different, even though the number of revolute pair and number of prismatic pairs are same. Okay, now as an inverse mechanism, what you have to do is, first you have to fix one of the link, and you need to see the mechanism and how it's been behaving. Okay, for RRRR, you may not observe much difference. Okay, but anyway, you do it and report it in your report for second practice. Okay, and in this one, once again, fix link, for example, link 1, and observe what sort of mechanism it's showing, and then do the same with fixing link 2, and then link 3, and then link 4. Okay, similarly, do the same for this one as well as for this one. Okay. So if you do that, you will be able to observe certain mechanisms like Oldham's coupling, elliptical tram, some Scott-Yark mechanism, and those mechanisms you will be able to observe from the inverse of these construction. Okay, so that's your practice too. You have to construct these different types of Faubourg mechanism, and you need to identify the inverse, and based on once you construct, observe it. You will be constructing it in GIMP software, and after that you will be observing it, and based on the observation or report your observation in your report on practice too. Okay. Thank you.